enter the rocket section. And the Titan II was the tallest, largest ICBM in the Air Force inventory. And this is it right here. I worked on the Titan II in the early 80s. This is a LR-87, stage 2. Rocket motor. Aerojet designed and built this. Liquid fuel. Aerozine 50 and rocket fuel. Hypergolic, and that was the start cart to get the engines rolling. Butterfly valves to open up the chambers, located right there and over there. You could literally stand next to this and put your hand on the outside of it and not burn your hands while it was running. Now, you wouldn't want to do that, but that's how cool those thrust chambers would stay. Titan II, the LGM-25C. We had three bases with these. Davis-Monthan Air Force Base, McConnell, Kansas, and Little Rock, Arkansas. Each base had 18 Titan II missiles. Little Rock and Kansas both incurred accidents and lost a missile at each. W-53 thermonuclear bomb. This is the reentry vehicle being mounted to the transportation cradle, and I got to do that many a time. And this is what it was inside of the warhead, which it was a 9 to 10 megaton yield, four times the size of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Titan One. We'll be right back. B-36 from above. B-58 Hustler. B-2 Bomber. This is a shuttle trainer. They are currently dismantling it to take it over to the next hangar. It's not an actual full-scale shuttle. It's just a trainer.